We're going to be looking at Section 8 properties in the Cleveland market. This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS, and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world. Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of the MLS Search Analysis Show here on Holton-Wise TV. I'm your host, James Wise, and this is a show where I work investors like you to help you guys start, build, or grow your real estate portfolios. Now, this property right here, it doesn't look that great, and I'll be honest with you, it's really not. It's a low-income property, but it's going to work for what my client Ghost is trying to do. 2911 Saratoga Avenue, Cleveland 44109, 4 days on the market, price $59.9. Now, Ghost, I think that is too high of a price point. Real quick, Ghost, just so me and you can get on the same page, right? You ordered a package of videos for me, right? And we were looking at duplexes and whatnot, and then you decided you wanted to switch gears after that. You want to look at some single-family homes where Section 8 tenants going to make sense. Okay, no problem, brother. Love that strategy. In addition, you were looking at doing some type of seller finance deals where you can get seller financing. And I saw you went in, you bought the real-time MLS feeds for the seller finance deals, which is very good. And everybody else who's watching, if you're interested in finding out the seller finance deals, you want to see the seller finance inventory, you click the property search for sale tab, you scroll down past the investment properties for sale show, MLS search analysis show, and you click here for MLS access, right? You get the direct MLS access to all the seller finance deals. We got over 5,000 realtors in the Cleveland market. Anytime one of them either put a single family home on the market that's available for seller financing, 2 to 4 units, or the 5-unit apartment buildings, you will get notified the moment it happens. You get my direct MLS access, which you have done that too, Ghost. Now, anytime, Ghost, you see those properties, know that, A, I'm sure you've already noticed the inventory is small. There's not going to be a million of them on the market at one time. You got to move quickly if you want to try to get those. But I got to talk to you. I got to level with you, brother. I'm referring to you as Ghost because you told me being anonymous is incredibly important to you. That's fine. That's cool. It doesn't bother me. When I work with you guys pay me up front, so I don't really give a shit who you are. It don't matter to me. I'm getting my money. But here's the thing, brother. Again, don't bother me, but with you trying to be as anonymous as humanly possible, I got to let you in on a secret, dude. That's not going to jive well with your plan to try to buy homes from sellers that are trying to do seller financing. When you are a buyer, guys, and you're trying to get a buyer, get a seller to write you a big-ass loan like that, guys, you got to get that seller to trust in you, to believe in you, okay? Being well-known is important. I probably buy like $1 million or $2 million of seller finance real estate a year because I'm pretty much the most well-known real estate investor in the Cleveland market. So when you're going into these deals, Ghost, these sellers, they're going to want to put you through the ringer. They're going to want to see your credit report, know who you are, know what you're about, because they're putting a lot of faith in you, because it's really freaking expensive to foreclose on a property if you were to stop paying your mortgage to them. So I just want to have you look at that from a strategy standpoint, right? If you want to try to do something, but the other part of your business strategy is completely opposite of that, you need to make the appropriate adjustments. So if you want to really build yourself a seller finance portfolio, brother, you're going to have to get rid of the fucking anonymous shit. That's not going to play anymore, bro. You're going to have to become a well-known person and have these sellers put their faith into you. Or you're just going to go with traditional financing and the property I found for you on this show, and I actually found you another two. Okay, so I'm going to go over those three where if you want to continue the anonymous thing, that's totally cool, brother. I dig it. I love it. I respect it. I understand why you'd want to be anonymous. I just want you to know that ain't going to jive with seller financing. Into the anonymousness, I don't know. But to that point, right, you asked me a couple questions. You asked me if you could buy your properties in a trust or an LLC and if the title companies we work with would have any issues with that. No, that's totally cool, bro. That's totally fine. You could totally buy your properties in an LLC, living trust. You set up whatever type of entities you want to shield yourself. But one thing I need to let you know, though, is it's going to be a financing issue, okay? with the seller financing. If you're trying to be super anonymous and all that crap, again, I don't think the seller's going to write you a loan, number one. But if you're trying to do bank financing, the bank also isn't going to write you a loan in your LLC or some type of living trust, right? So if you want to use financing, dude, you're going to have to put the properties in your name. But if you're able to finance the asset or you get that shit all figured out, the title company don't give a fuck. You buy however the fuck you want. They don't care.
Hey, lenders. Our investors are looking to work with you. Send us an email at sales@HoltonWiseTV.com.
All right, so yeah, man, that's that. So again, it's the financing, right? So actually, one other thing I have for you too, brother. In the show notes, I included a video about LLCs and when they make sense. And I can go into, in that video, I go into a little bit more detail about when LLCs do make sense for you. So, you know, again, the title companies, bro, they don't really care, but it really comes into play when you're trying to do your financing. So with all that said, let's get back to this particular property because I think being anonymous is important to you. And you can be anonymous to everybody but the bank in this type of scenario. So this one, though, dude, I think this is like the type of deal where you could really do some damage here. You could do some good stuff. Now, they want $59.9 for this thing, brother. Not going to work at $59.9. Here's why. They have a month-to-month tenant in there, a long-term tenant, and they're only paying $600 a month. So in my opinion, that's going to push out a lot of the real estate investors. A lot of investors are not going to want to buy this particular property because that rent's so low. And then, of course, the only other people that could buy properties like this are owner-occupied folks, but we're not going to see them going after this property because there's a long-term tenant in there, right? Which is why I think me and you can get a discount. I'd love to see you pick it up for $45,000. And here's the cool thing. Long-term, we get a long-term Section 8 tenant in there, bro. That's a $925 a month rental, bro. $925 a month, 11.1 comes in for the year. Your NOI is going to be almost $6,000 under normal circumstances, right? And you pick it up at $45,000 with that type of rent, dude. You only need $11,250 into the deal. The bank gives you 33.75. That's a 37.3% cash-on-cash return, dude. That would be a freaking home run deal. But the thing is, you got to remember, bro, currently you got a $600 tenant. We need to get that tenant up $325 to market rate. Now, my opinion on how to best do that to get the most return on your investment is to do it slowly. You don't just go in on day one like, yo, dude, your rent's $925 now. Because I think that tenant's moving out if you do that, right? You can't force their hand that much. They'll probably just move out, and then you're probably going to have to do like a $10,000, $15,000 turnover. I mean, we only got one photo, but the house is definitely run down, and it's older, right? So what you really want to do is get them in there. Get the discount up front, right? Pay only $45,000 because nobody else is interested in it because of the low rent situation. And then just slowly work that tenant up because you and I know the rent, it should be a lot higher, but we don't want to force that tenant out. Artificial turnovers kill our return. So I say you go in, you pick it up, increase the rent $50, and then wait a year, then do another 50, wait a year, do another 50, and then keep working it up that way. And if you can get them all the way up to 925 over the course of a few years, bro, you're looking at almost a 40% return on your investment. If not, you got to bust out a rehab, and then we get you a new Section 8 tenant in there, and we're right back up to 925. I think it makes sense. I think this is the type of deal you want to do, and I think your best bet is to buy it in your own name so you can get financing. But again, more info on the LLC stuff's in that other video. But if you're not feeling this deal, brother, I got two more single-family homes I want to show you, so we're going to look into the next one now.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to Holton Wise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.